world, it's Sabrina, or Salem Scissors, and I am here today to talk to you a little bit about bra history and a little bit about why bras can be bad for you. So let's get started with bra history. So around the 1300s, it was when they first saw women wearing something they would consider a bra. There were more bandeau-like things that would cover their breasts, seen in murals, of course, whereas up to this point, most women were painted or portrayed bare-breasted. Fun fact, Romans disliked big breasts. Now around the 16th century, around 1500s, that's when there was a major shift in women's undergarment and corsets were invented. What corsets did is they flattened women's breasts, pushing them up, almost falling out of their dresses, and the boning was made either out of wood or whale bones, literal whale bones. And of course, they were popular for almost four centuries. When we split away from the corset as we know it, and it turned more into what we call now a girdle, forcing the torso forward and forcing the hips outward, creating more of an S shape. Around 1869, the corset split into two. By guess who? The French. This lady decided to cut corset in half and have the top supporting the breasts with straps, while the lower part supported the waist, making it smaller. It wasn't until 1905 that they started selling the bras on their own. Now around 1907, the word brassiere was born, and it was added into the Oxford Dictionary in 1911. Now around 1910, due to the uncomfort of this new bra, the modern bra was created by Mary Phelps Jacob, using two handkerchiefs and silk ribbons. It wasn't until 1920s that flat was in. Small chested slender body flappers were the top thing in the roaring 20s. So we ditched the corsets completely and opted for tight bandeaus that flattened chests and gave more of a boyish shape. Now it wasn't until the 1930s that underwear became a thing and cup size emerged. Brassiere became bra and large scale productions began. It was a company called S.H. Camp & Company that created the sizes 8 through D and created the, well, not created, used the adjustable bands. Around 1940s, during World War II, the torpedo bra started selling to women in factories. They were targeted because it was claiming that it would provide protection for girls that worked in production lines. It wasn't until around the 1950s that Marilyn Monroe started the sweater girl look, wearing these bullet bras under sweaters and making a cup appear bigger. During 1960s, although no underwear and no lining was very popular, a Canadian lingerie company designed the Wonder Bra. It was the first of its kind to lift and push the bust line together, but it wasn't really that popular until the 90s. Now later on, it became popular to have leopard print and black lace bras, due mainly to Anne Bancroft's Mrs. Robinson. It wasn't until 1977 that the first sports bra was invented. Exercising and fitness became more popular, so women needed something to wear while doing this. This is when the jog bra hit the scene. Originally called jock bra, due to it first being designed made out of two jock straps tied together. 1977 was also the year that Victoria's Secret opened its first store in Palo Alto, California, created by Roy Raymond, who came up with the idea because he felt uncomfortable shopping in department stores like Macy's for his wife's undergarments. Why he was shopping for her undergarments still beats me, but he was uncomfortable. Then we move into the 1990s, where Madonna brought back the torpedo bra, and then to the 2000s, where strapless was a thing, and one strap, and then corset bras, memory foam bras, nude stick-ons, and so on and so forth. Now let's talk about science and a little bit of bras. Breasts weren't designed by nature to be harnessed by a bra. There is nothing medical that tells you it's good to wear a bra. They're simply a fashion accessory. Bras actually make your boobs sag. Now think about it as the rest of your body. For example, if you've ever broken a leg or if you've ever broken an arm, you know that when it's in its cast, it becomes really weak. When you take your cast off, you're losing muscle, you're all wobbly, and you feel like you have to either work out or use this muscle more. If you're constantly providing that support, then your boobs are automatically just going to let go. They're gonna let themselves be healed by the bra and not try and stay perky on their own. This was also proven by a 15-year-old study made by this guy, who also said, medically, physiologically, anatomically, breasts gain no benefit from being denied gravity. On the contrary, they get saggier with the bra. This professor conducted a study with hundreds of women between the ages 18 and 35. And he found out that women who never wore bras had apexes that were 7 millimeters higher in comparison to their shoulders, which meant that they had perkier breasts. Women could breathe easier, carry themselves better, and had less back pain as well. The orientation of the breasts was improved, meaning that they were not going different directions or they were not pointing downward. Now, studies says that push-up makes women feel more confident. And that's kind of been buried in our head by, guess what? Society and men. The tighter the better is no way of thinking. Push-up bras and tight padded bras restrict lymph fluid from your breast. Now, lymph nodes are little factories for white blood cells production, and they're essential parts of our immune system. Now, the lymph nodes, most of the lymph nodes for the breasts, are in the part of the body near the armpit. Now, that's the reason why your boobs sweat. It is not because of cleavage. Me, for example, I am really flat, and I actually sweat in the middle of my chest if I'm biking or if I'm out on a really hot day. That's because those lymph nodes are actually releasing all that fluid that my body does not need anymore. Normally, this fluid washes out waste materials and toxins away from breasts, but these kind of bras, padded and super tight ones, inhibit this action, and these toxins accumulate in the breast into cysts and can also help with the creating of cancer. Although it has not been proven directly that bras can cause cancer, it is not a factor that helps out against it. Now, some of these toxins that need to be let go by the bodies are PCBs, DDTs, dioxin, benzene, and other carcinogenic chemicals that cling to the body's fat tissue, like the breasts. Now let's talk about underwire. For some of you that may not know, this is what an underwire looks like. This is actually made out of metal coated in plastic. This is what you're putting against your skin. This is how hard this is. You shouldn't do this to your breasts, and this metal can cause problems. Underwires are right on top of some of those lymph nodes that we had just talked about. Just like any other kind of metal, if it has contact with your skin for long enough, it can cause serious problems. Don't wear underwire. You can actually take out the underwire from many of your bras by simply clipping the casing that it comes in and taking it out. Our lymph system is like the garbage disposal for your body, and it flushes out your toxins. Unlike your cardio system, however, the lymph node does not have a pump to move the fluid. Instead, the movement of our body is responsible for flushing out your toxins, which means, yes, your boobs are meant to bounce. Make sure you're wearing the right bra size. I'm not telling you to stop wearing a bra. I'm just telling you to find a comfortable bra. A bra that has no padding, a bra that has no underwire, a bra that will provide you that comfort that you can feel yourself. No one else needs to know. Non-padded bras or non-underwire bras can provide plenty of support as well. For instance, look at the bras I make myself. I have made bras for women that are up to 42 triple or double D, and they have felt just plenty of support from these bras without underwire. Don't sleep with your bra on. This is the stupidest thing that I've recently learned about, that some women sleep with their bra on because it's meant to make them not sag more. Go back and rewatch what I just said. So really think about this. Really go through your bras, try and see if they're your correct size. Look at my past video and learn about vanity sizing. And also be considerate that these, even though society tells you that they're for more, are for breastfeeding your children. Don't mistreat them, you'll need them one day. And if you haven't used them already, you will in the future, and they're very important for evolution and for the wellness of your child. Thanks for watching. Once again, I meant no offense to anybody. Please leave a comment or share, and thank you very much. Have a great day. Medically, physiologically, and anatomically.